Do you have a business problem or a conundrum or a decision that you're trying to make? I'm going to talk about how you can make decisions using SAS Viya. Specifically, I'll talk about how you can use visual analytics, visual statistics and visual data mining and machine learning, model manager and decision manager to explore your data, to build and compare and select the best model, and to finally make a decision. I'll use a simple example having to do with voter turnout. I recently heard on the radio that we were having record voting turnout here in the United States. Record turnout! I was so excited! Yes, record turnout, the radio announcer repeated. A whopping 49%! Wait, what? Did I hear that correctly? 49%? That is record turnout? I quickly pulled out an envelope and did some back-of-the-envelope calculations. Carry the one in. That's less than half. Yes, you heard right. Less than half of eligible voters voted in the U.S. general election in November 2018. And that was a record turnout for a midterm election. For convenience and demonstration purposes, I created a very small data set from 1980 to 2014 with just a few variables. Variables included state, year, education success score for state, percent high school graduates, percent ineligible felons, voting eligible population, voting age population, and so on. I first created a geo map to look at voter turnout by state. I can see that by the darkness of the color that Minnesota is one of the highest states. I can see that Texas is one of the lower states. If I look at my home state of Maryland, I see we fall about in the middle. So this is 49.3% of the voting eligible population voted in Maryland over the last, from 1980 to 2014. We can use ranking to look at the top 10 and bottom 10 voter turnout states. And we can look at voter turnout by voting eligible population and as a percentage of voting age population. One thing we notice here that jumps right out of this bar chart is that the midterm years, such as 1982, 86, 90, are much lower than the presidential election years, such as 1980, 84, 88, etc. See a big discrepancy here. In fact, I think I want to create a categorical variable in my data set. Here I create a categorical variable for election type. You see, I just used the year and I can determine if it's a presidential or midterm election. Now I can use election type, my new categorical variable, as an input to my modeling down the road. So back to my hypothetical situation. Let's say I want to call a friend to whine about low voter turnout. I don't want to inadvertently call a friend who did not vote because then I will have to listen to all her lame excuses. Like she was getting a massage or she had to reorganize her sock drawer, those kinds of things. So at any rate, I want to figure out which of my friends most likely voted so that I can call that one. So together, let's use visual analytics, visual statistics, visual data mining and machine learning to build some models, and we'll use model manager and decision manager to manage those models and make a decision. My first step is to decide which variables are pertinent for my modeling effort. I'll start by making a correlation matrix of most of my measure variables. I see that many of my variables are highly correlated with each other. So I'm going to eliminate my highly correlated input variables because I know they're going to make my model volatile and they're duplicative. Now that I've pared down my input variables, I can create a model directly from this page. I press down the Alt key so that it will duplicate on a new page, and I'll duplicate as a decision tree. Now I notice that I only have input variables that are measures. I want to add my election type categorical input. And I want to add a partition ID. Notice that although I have now a categorical input as one of my inputs, my target is still a number. And so this is a regression decision tree as opposed to a classification decision tree. Now, is decision tree the best model I could have used? I don't know. I can actually so easily create other models that I'm going to go ahead and create a couple more models right here just by duplicating on new page, pressing the Alt and this snowman icon, and I can duplicate on new page as a forest model and as a linear regression model. Notice that my roles are the same as I had in the decision tree because I duplicated my roles, my assessment criterion, which is the validation, average squared error. These are all the same because I duplicated this. So I have the same inputs, the same response, the same partition, everything. So now I have three models that I can compare. Be aware that I could also compare in the Model Studio Pipeline interface, but I can compare models right here in the interactive interface. So I'll do that. From my Objects pane under SAS Visual Statistics, I find my model comparison object and I'll drag that in. I'll select all to include my decision tree, my forest, and my linear regression. I see that my forest model is selected here, and I want to look at both training and validation assessments over here because I see that the validation average square error was used to determine which was the best model. Now I'm going to look at a pipeline in Model Studio, and I could create that pipeline from an individual model, but I'm going to create it right here from my comparison. And you see when I click on this snowman, I can create pipeline and I can add it to a new project. I see I have a data node, my interactive data prep node. My interactive forest model was the only model that came through. Why is that? That was the best model based on my model comparison in the interactive interface. And I also have a model comparison node here. So let me add a couple more models here in Model Studio. I can do that simply by right-clicking on my data prep node, add below, supervised learning. I'll pick a generalized linear model. And I'll pick a gradient boosting model. Now I'll run this to see which is the best. Let's look at our results. We see the gradient boosting model is the champion. And we see that it was selected using the average squared error from the validation data. Recall that Model Manager lets us register or store our models in a repository. We can bring these models in from, for example, the SAS Visual Analytics interface, the Model Studio pipeline interface, or the SAS Studio interface, or we can bring them from outside of Viya. We can bring them from SAS 9. We can bring PMML models. We can bring lots of different models written in other coding languages into Model Manager. We can compare our models there and select the champion model, and we can monitor model performance. We can also publish models, for example, to the SAS Microanalytics Service, to CAS, to Teradata, to Hadoop, etc. In this way, we can let these models score in an external application or interface. From the Pipeline Comparison tab, I can register a model. I check the model, I go to the snowman, and I register the model. Once my model is registered, I can go to the hamburger at the top. I can find Manage Models and go to Model Manager, and I'll see my model registered there. I'll sort by date modified, and here I see the model that I just registered, the gradient boosting model pipeline that was created from it, started out as a creation from it, the interactive interface. If I go to my Projects tab in Model Manager, I can see my projects and where they're located. I can select a project, and I can look at the history of that project. Who modified it and when? Let's say there's a model I want to publish. I'm going to pick this forest model, and I'm going to publish that using the snowman icon in the upper right corner and selecting Publish. I can publish this to CAS or to Teradata, Hadoop, or MAS, Microanalytic Service. I see I published successfully. And I can close. Model Manager provides lots of information on the models. If I select a model from my model list, I can see the code associated with that model, the SAS file, the JSON files. I can look at the variables. What are the input and output variables? The properties. I can see the modeler here, who modeled it, the tool used to create the model. And I can also look at my versions. So in our example, we've created five different models very quickly and easily. We compared them, selected a champion, we registered and published models, and we let Model Manager track our model versions. Now we're ready to make an actual decision to call or not to call my friend. So I have to decide how likely is my friend to have voted. And I can do that easily. I will set up a flow in Decision Manager. To get to Decision Manager, I'll go again to my hamburger, Manage Decisions. I can add a model from my repository. I can pick a variable from that model to make a decision on. I'm going to use my prediction variable, and I'm going to say if it's greater than 0.6, I'll make my decision based on that. I can decide what to do if it's a yes. I can go to a rule set that I've created and say follow these rules if I have a yes. And I can go to the no side and add another rule set. And now I've made my decision based on the predictive likelihood that someone would have voted, and I can decide to call my friend or to do something else. So I walked you through visual analytics, visual statistics, visual data mining and machine learning, model manager and decision manager, a really quick overview to show how I could you solve a real world problem, a question or a decision that I had using these tools. Your decisions may be more complicated, your data sets might be much more complicated, but you can use this same process to make decisions for your organization or for yourself. For more information, see the Model Manager's User's Guide and documentation, the Decision Manager documentation. Here are the data sets that I used if you're interested. I'm Beth Ebersole from SAS. I hope this was helpful.